Okay, this one's called Gorky Park. I missed the breaking season when I was in Singapore, so this is when the last break is around. I thought I'd do this one a little different. Two things I've taken away from the round pen and bring them out here in the open paddock. See what we can do out here. Another thing is I'm not going to put a saddle on her or a roller. I'm just going to do this bareback. There's a few reasons I want to do this. One is because I've started a lot of horses and a lot of them bucked when I did do the roll up the first time. So if we take that out of the equation, there shouldn't really be any reason for her to buck. All we have to do is get her to accept the rider and put a mouth on her a little bit. A lot of horses buck putting the rider on and then they'll buck again when the rider gets on. But this way, All I really got to do is get her to accept me on her back and she should start coming around. Another reason is you don't really know unless you try. I know there's risks involved, but I could be taken out by some idiot on the road on the way home. So if I'm going to be taken out, I'd rather do it myself. Now, I don't recommend everybody do this. I'm doing it because I want to get better, I want to learn, I can pick up a lot from this experience. I think nothing's going to go to plan, so I've got an idea how it's going to go. But unless I try, I won't know. And next time I do this, I'll know what went wrong today, and I'll try not to repeat them next time. Experimenting is the best way to learn as well. Even though I'm doing this, you guys can see what's going on, and you can pick something up as well. Towards the end, we'll go over what went wrong, what we could have done, what things didn't go according to plan. And we can have a little discussion about that later if you like, but hopefully it's pretty straightforward. As you can see, what I'm doing now is just taking the edge off a little bit. As with the roller horse, the house call vid, I let him muck around for 8 minutes first. This way I'm just going to go straight to the point and slow it down. And just jump on. Unlike the filly in the house call vid the other day where they tried three times to get the roller on in the round pen, I've got the upper hand here because she doesn't know what I want to do. So she's not going to be mentally prepared. She won't have a plan A ready. So that way I can take charge and take over and hopefully get things right the first time. What I've done is I've turned her head round to the side. I've shut down the flight response so she can't get away. That'll give me a chance to jump on a few times. As you can see, she's so far so good. She's not running away too much. I let her head go to let her know that she's not going to be stuck like that for an hour. Just small steps. When I do get on her back, I'll probably have three main goals. One will be to get her moving, get her going forward. The other one will be put a mouth on her. And the third goal will probably get her to give up all resistance and actually accept me on her back and let her be content with it. I could turn her head to either side. I was just thinking if I turn her head to the knee side, she might get a fright if I jump up. So it's a lot better. If I turn to the off side there where she can't see me jump, she can just feel my weight on her. There's not really much to panic about there. It's basically just weight on her back. Okay, she had a little bit of a struggle, but she slowed right down now. Okay, so far so good. That's about 4 minutes and 20 seconds. I'm on her back now, so should be all downhill from now. Okay, so sit back and put some music on and we'll do this Gorky Park. It'd be Dorky Park if I fell off. And we'll work out what we did right and wrong at the end and what worked out, what didn't work out. And we'll try and learn something from this. And I'll see you in a bit.
Thank you. Moscow down to Gorky Park, listening to the wind of change. August summer night, soldiers passing by, listening to the wind of change. We could be so close, like brothers. The future's in the air, can feel it everywhere. I'm blowing with the wind of change.
Okay, that wasn't too bad for a first day, so just go over what went wrong or what we could have done better and see if we can improve them next time. Okay, the first problem I had, her stable was across the road. She come in from the gate. She knows where the gate is. And of course, she's going to head back to the gate. The gate's going to drag her in like a magnet every time I go near it. Every now and then, she'd turn around and head towards the gate herself, which is okay because I didn't have to push her. She was going freely, getting away from the gate, had to push her constantly. Another thing I didn't anticipate was the snow in the paddock wasn't even all the way around towards the fence over the back there. There was ice under the snow and it was crunching and when she walked on it, which didn't give her a good feel, so she didn't really want to go over that way. So next time it'll be around October, November, I won't have that snow problem, so that's one problem I won't have to deal with. The gate problem, I'd take her to a paddock that's probably 3-4 times bigger than this one. I originally thought this would be big enough to do the job, but obviously it wasn't. Of course, it's bigger than a round pen, but there still wasn't enough room for it to break into a hack going from one side of the paddock towards the gate. So I would have liked to do the three gates, the walk, trot, and the hack around. But I could only do the walk, and she broke in a trot a few times. So I just have to settle for that for today. It's only her first day. A bigger paddock will give me more smooth runs to the gate, even though I might have to push them away from the gate to give me more distance to break in a few different gates. Let them break in a trot, ease them up again, and break in a little canter, ease them up again. It'll be a lot more smoother than trying to push all the time. So that's one thing I do different, choose a bigger paddock. The rest was pretty normal. I took the rough edges off her teeth before I bring her out here, so I didn't get much of a fight there mouthing her. She didn't have a roller on, so she wasn't really bucking there. So it was pretty much expected. And it'll give me something to work with tomorrow. I'll saddle her up tomorrow and ride around the little track inside there. I think she's pretty quiet. So it wouldn't take long for her to come around and the guy that owns the farm start riding himself. So we can do another update on her later anyway. Okay, so that's Gorky Park. Gorky Park's actually a park in Russia. I know it's not Russia, but it's just as bloody cold. I'll see you next time.